Well, I'm so happy to deliver this baby. I guess I'm on the Jennifer track because she's carrying some hope for the future, and so does this film. So I'm really excited about tonight. Really hope people like it. Adam wrote the film before the lockdown, and then everything stopped for 5 months, and they went away and then recouped, and we all masked up and shielded up and came to set. And it was hard to get back into playing with each other and making it alive. And yeah, but we got into it, and we got into the hardship of it, and we got into the fact that that's what the movie's about, is all the denial of science and all the things that are leading us to a brick wall. So it was really a joy. I had worked with Leo, well, I thought it was like 10 or 12 years, this was 25 years ago, and he was a baby. He was 18 and in Marvin's room, and now to come back and work with him again, he's grown to be such an interesting, intelligent, committed, gifted man, and his work in this is, I think, the best he's ever been in a career of highs. So yeah, I was thrilled to work with him. Never worked with Jennifer before, and she's a joy. So pure, so straight ahead, so true. She's our Greta Thunberg, and everybody else. Never worked with Mark Rylance, this genius that I've revered all my life, and Cate Blanchett, and oh my God, Tyler Perry, Ariana Grande, how great is she in this movie? And Kid Cudi, and I mean, it's just, it goes on and on and on. Oh, and Jonah Hill, who kind of was a thorn in my side. He played my son, my chief of staff as president. And he was hilarious, but he did make me laugh all the time, and then they had to cut because you're not supposed to laugh at the other actor in the movie, you know. So that was a problem, but it was great. It was really fun.